We can derive the formula from mass percent data, but of course the formula that we're deriving is the empirical formula. In this short video, we want to look at the relationship between the molecular formula for a molecular compound and its empirical formula. Let's take a look at some data. In this case, elemental analysis was used to determine the percent mass or the percent composition of eucalyptol. And from this elemental data, it was found that the elements, carbon, oxygen, and hydrogen, were present in the compound in these percentages. Well, we assumed that we had a 100-gram sample, and then we converted these percentages to grams to moles, then we converted to moles, and we found that the whole number ratio for eucalyptol was C10H18O. Now, that's the empirical formula for eucalyptol. So the empirical formula for eucalyptol was C10H18O. The question is that also the molecular formula for eucalyptol? Well, the one piece of information that we need to have in order to make that determination is the molar mass for eucalyptol. And the molar mass for eucalyptol is 154 grams per mole. That was found in a separate experiment. All right, so we know the molar mass and we know the empirical formula. We want to know if the empirical formula is actually the molecular formula. The way we determine this is that we know that the molecular formula, I'm just going to abbreviate it MF, the molecular formula for any compound equals some whole number coefficient n times the empirical formula for that compound. All right, and so we can determine what this value n is using molar mass data. So I'm going to abbreviate molar mass of the molecular formula equals n, some whole number coefficient, times the molar mass of the empirical formula. So we can take the the molar mass of the molecular formula and divide it by the molar mass of the empirical formula to determine what n is. All right, and so in this case, I know that the molar mass is equal to 154 for the molecule that was found in a separate experiment. Now I need to determine what is the molar mass of the empirical formula. I do that just by adding up, you know, the molar mass of the empirical formula. So in this case, it's C10, so it's 10 times 12 plus 18 plus 16 for oxygen. So I did the math previously and found that the molar mass of the empirical formula was also 154 grams per mole. So 154 divided by 154 equals 1. In this case, that's telling me that the molecular formula is the same as the empirical formula. So the molecular formula is also C10H18O.